Welcome back to ESPN College Football Primetime, presented by Jimmy John's. Welcome back to Merlin Olsen Field at Romney Stadium, where the visitors from San Jose State are putting up more of a fight than many expected. Two runs by that man. The offense, while Coach Carragher's team hanging in here with a third-string quarterback down by seven on the road. But the Aggies will get the ball to start the third quarter.
Yeah, how about that? One team starting with their fourth starter of the season. Now San Jose State on their third quarterback of the season.
Austin Lopez on to start things off here for the second half. This is Jalen Davis. Across the 20, across the 30. Taken out of bounds at the 44. No flag, so good field position to start the third quarter for the Aggies. Eamon McEnany along with David Diaz Infante, Allison Williams down on the field. And if you're Utah State, you have the lead, but they haven't been executing the way they have in this winning streak.
Yeah, they really haven't. The big part of their offense has been their quarterback. He's has over half their rushing yards. And then you got to give credit to San Jose State's defense, too. Take away those two plays. They've done a great job containing this offense. And offensively for San Jose State, they've been able to get something done running the football. And their quarterbacks come in, Matt Revisa, and done a great job taking care of the football.
And now here's an alley for JoJo Natson at the 30. One man to beat. He won't get him. Just like that. 56 yards. The junior from Fort Lauderdale does it again for the Aggies. Been the explosive play here tonight for the Aggies.
So JoJo Natson is one of our impact players of the game. You see the speed he has again, running back in the boundary is where Utah State's had success offensively. And there's not too many people that have the ability to catch JoJo Natson once he gets out in space. He had a 48-yard touchdown run last week as well.
There you see the only FBS player with multiple touchdowns rushing, receiving, and in the return game.
And explosive plays against the San Jose State defense has been their Achilles heels, especially here tonight. A 28-yard touchdown run, a 60-yard run, and now a 56-yard touchdown run accounting for all 21 of Utah State's points.
Neither half has started off well for the Spartans. First half, first play of the game, they lost their quarterback, Blake Jurich, when he hurt his knee while getting sacked, and now they give up the 56-yard touchdown run to Natson. So now Irvin and Crawley back. To be Crawley from the 12. He is dropped at the 24. Let's check in down on the field with Allison Williams.
San Jose State coach Ron Carragher very pleased with how his quarterback Mitch Revisa performed in that first half. He said he's gutsy, he's feisty, has all the intangibles you want in a quarterback, and especially encouraged when you consider the first time he took snaps with the ones and twos was in practice this week. But it is interesting to know, guys, Blake Jurich, the starter coming into this game, has been medically cleared. I asked Carragher if Mitch started to struggle, if he would go to Jurich. He said, boy, that's really tough to say because Revisa's playing so well, but it would be a gut feel.
All right, Allison, thanks for that update. Now on the kickoff return, Tim Crawley, the sophomore running back, being tended to by the training staff, so we will step aside from Logan, Utah. Tim Crawley was able to come off the field on his own power, so hopefully for the Spartans he'll be able to return. But now Mitch Revisa, as you see Crawley being looked at that right knee. And Revisa to throw with time, looking deep. And he overshoots his man, Hansel Wilson. Good coverage by Devin Centers, who's been busy here tonight.
Devin Centers on the coverage quarterback.
Really the first time San Jose State's trying to push the ball vertically down the field with Revisa. Overthrew that ball a little bit.
Here's a look at Blake Jurich. As Allison told us, could possibly return to this game, has been medically cleared to return, but obviously sticking with the hot hand of Revisa, who moved the offense effectively in the first half. Now they give it to Irvin. Irvin in the open field. Irvin with the juke, gets out to the 45.
And number seven, Tyler Irvin.
Terra with the tackle, 22-yard gain.
A good job by that offensive line. You'll see him. He's ready for that football. A little inside zone play right up the gut. You see Irvin was looking for that little bit of daylight to take it to the house.
We'll go right back to him. Tough sledding here, maybe a yard or two.
Tyler Irvin.
Jordan Nielsen with the tackle. The Tyler Irvin show in the running game for the rest of the night here. There are not too many other options to go to right now. So the running game has been effective.
Well, that's 2 weeks in a row. Obviously, New Mexico State, an entirely different type of an offense. Well, they put up some good numbers against this defense as well.
Revisa looking to throw. Good coverage, but he gets it to Winston. Jalen Davis on the coverage. Yeah, looks like it'll be third and five. Third and four, we'll call it. Quarterback draw was effective in the first half. We have not heard from Jabari Carr, the big playmaker in the passing game. He's at the bottom of your screen to the left. Revisa keeps it and gets outside, but gets brought down short. Zach Vigil with another tackle, and Nick right there as well.
You're going to see some great instincts and great reaction time by Zach Vigil. You'll see Revisa's going to think he has that edge. Watch Zach Vigil change direction, come off the inside move, and make that tackle short of the first down.
It looks like they're going to go for it. Zach Vigil now with 14 tackles. David, what do you think of this call here? Fourth and two, down by 14.
I have no problem with it.
Again, out of the gun. And now they take a timeout as the play clock is running out. So will they change their minds? We're back after this.
ESPN College Football Primetime is brought to you by Infiniti, luxury cars that deliver inspired performance, and the U.S. Army. Some are driven by expectations, some defy them. Find your career at goarmy.com/defy.
Amber Lee Snyder is the president of the Utah State Rodeo Club. She's a highly decorated competitive rodeo rider who was injured in a car accident that left her paralyzed from the waist down. She's now back and riding and competing again. And after the timeout, they do fake it. And it looks short. They snapped it to the up man, Shane Smith. And the Aggies were ready for it. It's so they had to get to the 49-yard line with number 49. the 44-yard line. We're going to bring out the chains.
And they ran that right up the gut.
Not very close at all, and it's easy for me to second guess up here, but a fake punt after a timeout when they had time to get ready for it. They certainly were ready for it.
You'll see they got to get to the 44-yard line. His knee is down. The ball is down. That's a good spot by the officials.
DDI, I know you said you had no problem with them going for it. What do you think of the fake after a timeout?
I'd rather run an offensive play, unless you had something on their personnel or formation.
Now that's it again. Pushed out of bounds by Vince Fulhauser. I'd like to see a 100-meter yard race between Datsun and Irvin. Those guys can fly in the open field. And it's a 15-yard pickup.
And especially when you get the handoff at almost full speed,
right,
how quick you get the perimeter is really amazing.
Now they empty the backfield on first and 10. Myers keeps it.
Hit Myers on the
gets
keeper.
Hit by Deshaun. Dyson Frierson. Gain of three.
It's a nice little package that a lot of teams run right now with that fly sweep and a quarterback power up inside of it or off of it. It's a nice little package.
Coach is off the way. Coach is off the way.
Joe Hill in the backfield. There's a fly sweep to Robinson. CD and Buhajer ready for that one.
Pitch two, number three, Devontae Robinson. On the tackle, number three, Travis Rossiti.
Pickup of two, which makes it third and six. And boy, do Rossiti and the Spartans need to stop here the way this half's going right now. Already down by two scores. Now Natson back out there, not much of a break for number nine. Myers looking to throw, looking for Natson, complete for a first down. What a move for a few extra yards. It is the JoJo Natson show right now in Logan, Utah.
A great matchup and design right here by putting Natson in the backfield to get him matched up on a linebacker. Buzarja right here in and out. He's going to win that matchup every time by leverage and speed and athleticism.
Pickup of 11. First and 10 at the 25. That's it now in motion into the slot. Myers looking for him again. And he can't hang on. The freshman Maurice McKnight delivering the blow.
That one's going to hurt a little bit. Kent Myers hung in there, took a hit, and so did JoJo Natson.
It's the old buddy pass when you float it up like that over the middle.
The safety hanging.
So now second and 10. Spartan showing pressure off the edge, and here it comes. Rossiti throws Hill down. Loss of two.
Travis Rossiti, one of those graduated seniors for San Jose State that they're really good. Miss had a great career here for the Spartans. I like the way he plays the game. Tough player, active, got some quicks to him, and they need him to step up right here. Find a way to get a stop this Utah State defense.
Myers, been keeping himself on the quarterback draw. Flag on the play. First down if it stands as he... He's able to keep his feet, go out of bounds at the 10, but let's see what the call is.
Holding, offense, number 72, 10-yard penalty, still third down.
So now the Aggies moving out of field goal range. Would have been a 17-yard gain.
You see Tyshawn Mosley right there. Yeah, he's got the jersey and waistline, vi. the defensive lineman for San Jose State.
Follow Evod filling in for Tony Popovich. So now it's third and 22, all the way back at the 38. And here's Natson, changing direction. This time, Jimmy Pruitt. Adrian Blake in on the play, so the Aggies look like they'll go field position and punt here. Last week, Jerron Bentrude was lights out in the kicking game. Four punts inside the 22 were downed at the one, and that's what they're looking for him to do here. Irvin wants to get his hands on it, make a big play. Irvin with the fair catch signal at the 10.
Fair catch by Irvin.
So the Spartans get it back, down by two scores. The crosstown rivalry heats up as the Bruins host the Trojans in a pivotal showdown in the Pac-12 South. Saturday night football, number 19 USC against number 9 UCLA, Saturday at 8 Eastern on ABC.
Two pretty good quarterbacks playing right there.
That's for sure.
Brett Hundley's been on fire this second half of the season. Look at the touchdown interception ratio of Cody Kessler.
Good to see Tim Crawley back on the field for San Jose State, but not much doing for Tyler Irvin on that inside run. David, can you start to try to force it to Jabari Carr? He's a graduate student, 148 career receptions, and he's just not been involved in the game offensively tonight.
I don't know if you could force it, but you could design something to him on the outside. You've got to trust your quarterback to go where the ball should go.
Trips to the right. High throw, looking for Carr. Over the middle. Vigilant, Zach Vigilant coverage. So now third and 11 on their own 10.
Good protection by San Jose State. Mitch Revisa just missed that throw.
So now Carr bottom of your screen left. Tyler Winston at the top of your screen to the right. It's a draw to Irvin. It's out to about the 22. Excuse me, the 17, well short of the first down. Another tackle by the Vigil brothers, Nick and Zach.
Yeah, Nick flipped him by the ankles and Zach finished him off. Tell you what, Zach Vigil, the more I watch him play, he's a guy that loves the game, plays with great energy and passion, and is very productive. I'm impressed with him as a football player.
High but short, Natson says get away. And it takes a Spartan bounce. Down at the 32.
Yeah, you talk about playing that linebacker position. This guy that loves to practice. He's fired up. He's the emotional leader of this football team. And he loves the game. He plays in the opposing offense's backfield. He's a sure tackler. He plays with just enough violence you got to have to play this game at a high level. And just how productive are these Vigil brothers? That tells a story right there. How about that, huh?
30 combined tackles for the senior and the sophomore. And they had to wait to college to play together. And certainly can have a lot of play on words with that last name, and that's a pretty creative sign there.
I like that.
One hunt up the middle, tackled by Cedric Losey.
It's funny, I was talking to one of the pro scouts about Vigil, Zach, and I go, look, I don't know how many boxes he jumps over, how fast he runs between the cones, but that guy is a football player, and I'd want him on my team.
And they had to wait to get to college to play together, couldn't play together in Little League.
A former walk-on, too. Yeah.
Matson again. Spartan territory. blocked by Hunt on the play. So again, as we came on the air tonight, talking about what's on the line still for Utah State to clinch the Mountain West Mountain Division. They must win tonight and then at Boise State next week, and they need Colorado State to lose one of its two remaining games.
I tell you what, that Mountain Division is jam-packed at the top.
This is Butler on the swing pass for a first down.
Butler on the reception.
Tackle by King.
Tackle by Maurice McKay.
Here's what David Diaz and Fonte were referring to. Take a look at the standings. A trio of teams right now at 5-1.
There's a dividing line right there. All four of those teams have a shot somehow, some way, to play in that championship game.
Hunt up the middle.
And
you know, in this new era, the inaugural college football playoff, you know, you think about the whole total resume and every game impacting, you know, who's going to be in the four. Ole Miss is sitting there. Hey, Boise, run that table. We got to win over Boise State. They couldn't improve our resume. I know conventional wisdom says Ole Miss is already out of it with two losses, but I think they have two nice wins out of conference that no one thought about. Boise State and Memphis. If Memphis can win the American Athletic Conference.
And well, they have a very good chance to do. What a job they've done down there in Memphis.
Coach,
they're a good football team.
Yeah, Coach yeah. Justin Fuente.
It's got their second time out of the half.
San Jose State takes a timeout. We'll step aside as well. Back here in Logan, Utah, Eamon McEnany along with David Diaz Infante, Allison Williams down on the field. And David, we saw the standings, just how tight everything is in the Mountain Division. Next week, if the score here holds, Utah State going to Boise State, and that one's going to be an impressive, very important, critical game.
Yeah, and a tough environment at Boise State at night for really all the marbles. Those teams are both in it. Boise State is the one team that controls their destiny all the way. Done a great job down there. Coach Harson's got that staff rolling. That football team's well. They play well on both sides of the ball.
Matson in the open field again. He gets to the pylon. They say he stepped out of bounds at the three. Akeem King pushed him out. What a second half here. Third quarter for JoJo Natson.
Hey, can you still win
that? In, out, right there at the three. Good job by the officials. Left hand out as well before he hit the pylon, but 28 yards.
Another explosive play by that Utah State offense.
It has been a one-man show here in the third quarter. Now they give it to Hunt. No, Myers keeps it, gets to the edge, and scores his third of the night. He is in the end zone for a touchdown on the replay.
And you got to give Utah State credit. They chipped away at this run game.
He's go 68 yards in six plays in 2 minutes and 12 seconds.
You know, one thing you talked about, what we've been so impressed with Matt Wells and his staff is how they've been creative in the run game and making something work without a guy that can really hand the ball off 30 times to. And, you know, Natson on the outside, use their speed and skill. Now their quarterback becomes a big part of the running game here tonight, and it changes week in and week out. He did a great job of designing and working around the personnel and injuries.
Last year in Chestnut Hill, Boston College had Florida State on the ropes before the Seminoles emerged with a road victory. Tomorrow afternoon at 3:30, it's number 3 Florida State hosting the Eagles, 3:30 Eastern on ABC or ESPN2. Steve Adazio looking, you know, to force their will on Florida State with the ground game. And there's a look at the Eagles on Friday Focus. And then, of course, keeping things in perspective, the Florida State community with a chance to come together That's what will be on their helmets after the shootings at the library earlier this week, Wednesday night, late Wednesday night. Here's Irvin from the five. Gets out near the 25. Let's check in with Allison Williams.
Well, you mentioned the ribbons that Florida State will wear on their helmets in light of that shooting the other night at the university's campus. And pretty scary when you consider some of the football players had just left the library. In fact, Derek Mitchell was there when it all happened. So Jimbo Fisher had a message to his team, and he basically told them, take each day as a blessing because you never know what the next day will bring. And there will be also a special video played before the game and a moment of silence after the very scary scene there at Florida State.
All right, Allison, thank you very much. And unfortunately, an all too occurrence right now in our society where we see sports as a chance for the communities to rally together after moments of violence. We saw that a few weeks ago with the NHL up in Canada. First call to Seafelt, pushing Irvin back. Loss of one. And Revisa gets sacked. B.J. Larson breaking through. The senior from right here in Logan, Utah.
Came into the game with seven sacks. He's athletic. He's got some length. Look at him, just going to use the power rip inside and overpower the left guard for San Jose State and get the sack, his eighth of the season.
So now third and 18 as they are going backwards. Here comes more pressure. And Revisa can't get away. Jordan Nielsen again. Larson there as well. Another punt for Michael Carrizosa. Another opportunity for JoJo Natson to get his hands on the ball. Punt goes out of bounds as they try to keep it away from Natson. And they spotted at the 46 of San Jose State. So just you give up field position to make sure you don't give up the touchdown, just a 30-yard punt.
If you're doing that, you get to drive it a little farther down the field. And you know, special teams have been an issue for San Jose State this season. And punting game is just a part of that.
So now they go Wildcat with Joe Hill. To the left, it's inside the 45. David, you're up three touchdowns. You mentioned you're down to your fourth string quarterback already. You going to the Wildcat to save hits, or you going to the Wildcat as strategy?
I think part of the strategy right now is, one, they've been creative in how they run the football, but it's always a part of what you give your next opponent. That'd be Boise State something to look at.
Tackled by Travis Rossidi. You know, David, throughout the week leading up to this game, you've been very impressed by the job Matt Wells and his staff have done here. You know, four different quarterbacks, four different running backs, six different wide receivers in the starting lineup. We could go on and on. You certainly can't cut and paste the depth chart here
right
for the Aggies. You know the game here in college coaching, college football. That coaching carousel is going to start up some big time jobs, and there's always dominoes that fall from that.
Well, he's a guy people are going to be interested in. I can tell you that right now. The job he's done here, their staff as a whole. But remember, he went to school here. He's a part of this place.
Myers complete to Robinson down to the 15. He came with the tackle.
And it'll be interesting to see what kind of phone calls he gets. I know this much. It'd take a lot for him to leave here. I think this is home for him in a lot of ways. the success they've built, and really, you know, his time here with Coach Anderson and building upon the foundation that was laid there, knowing what they had, not trying to change too much, adding his own flavor. And what they've done offensively and they continue to do defensively has been really impressive. And they've got depth. They know how to recruit. I mean, look, this is their fourth-string quarterback that's coming here and played pretty darn well. Not a lot of teams could say that. And I'm just very impressed with, one, the type of guy he is. When you sit down and talk to him, he's a very real guy, very humbled in the opportunities that have been afforded him. And what they've just done a great job of coaching their tails off. And that should be recognized, and you're often rewarded for it.
So the junior cornerback Jimmy Pruitt down on the field for San Jose State. Earlier in the first half, he came up with the interception on the wide receiver pass. Let's take a look and see how he got hurt. He was coming up to make the tackle. With that left shoulder.
He's involved in the run game. The way they play their coverages, those corners are very active for San Jose State. And think about this game here tonight. It didn't come real easy for them. They had to kind of work this thing through, find out what was working, keep flipping through the chart, who they getting the ball to, how they get it to them. But in the end, look what happens. They found the playmaker, JoJo Natson, the quarterback.
So Pruitt able to get up, but obviously favoring that left shoulder.
Yeah, it looks like he went in hard with his left shoulder. Yep. Took a shot on it.
Again, this is a defense that started the night down two starters, Christian Tago and Tony Popovich out. And here's Butler at the quarterback position. Looks like he might have lunged forward enough for a first down. 4-yard pickup, so it'll actually be short. Myers back on the field for third and short. Now they go under center. To Hill. He has the first down inside the 10. McKnight with the tackle. 7-yard pickup.
Good to see Joe Hill back in lineup. He's a very good player for him. He's been banged up. See a knee brace on one of his knees there. And a healthy Joe Hill makes this Utah State offense a little bit better.
Senior out of Fullerton, California. First and goal from the 9 to end the third quarter. Gets a little bit closer. So that'll do it for the third quarter, dominated by Utah State and JoJo Natson.